Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. This is episode 2 of my precious metal refining series, and today we're going to be doing some actual gold jewelry. Now I got my super inaccurate Walmart scale here, and a lot of you had mentioned that there's a little switch on the back that you can push to switch it between ounces and pounds to grams and kilograms, which I've done, and obviously messed up the zero here. But now the scale is much more accurate. You can see that it measures in 300 grams. See, this is the kind of thing that I have to deal with. Look at this. Okay, so now it measures in grams, which is much more accurate than the ounces that it was measuring in. And I have here some gold jewelry, which I'll weigh up. You can see I've got 32 grams of gold jewelry here, which is 14 karat. And that's, of course, including the gemstones. So I guess the first thing I need to do is get rid of those stones. And by the way, since the last episode, I've actually ordered a precision scale like the one you'd use in chemistry, which measures out to the milligram. So I'm pretty excited for it, and hopefully it'll get here before I'm doing all of these things that need a bit more precision for weighing the smaller bead that'll come out of it. You can see I've removed the gemstones from the rings. Now I know you guys are going to ask, so this one is definitely a diamond, this is a pearl, and this here is an amethyst. I'm not quite sure what these two are, but I'm a geologist and I'll probably figure it out soon. You might notice that there's a little bit of weight lost. This was 32 grams, now it's 31. That's because there was a lot of dirt inside of this ring here that I dug out, so definitely lost a bit of weight there. The way that I got the gemstones out, most of them I was able to just pry the little fingers up and then the gemstone fall out nicely. This one here I had to open with a pair of cutters. Okay, so now let's see what these weigh without the gemstones. It should be pretty easy. It's now 28 grams, so it's lost about 3 grams worth of rocks. Some of these rocks might be valuable and I'll keep them around for later projects, but until then, let's start working on this gold. Now this ring here, you'll notice, is actually a different color than the other ones, because this is actually white gold. You can see it's a silvery color rather than the gold tone. And that's because this is alloyed with either nickel or palladium. And I guess it'd be a good idea for me to check to see which one it is alloyed with, whether nickel or palladium. I have a pretty easy test for that. You see, palladium is a platinum group metal, and if I heat it up, it will not oxidize, whereas nickel will oxidize almost immediately. So let's warm this up a little bit in this fire and see what happens to it. If it oxidizes, that'll confirm that it's nickel, and I'll just add it to the other metals because it won't really change anything. If it's palladium, I'd have to do a different whole process in order to purify it. So I'd have to make another video out of it. Yeah, it's definitely oxidizing. It's definitely discoloring from the fire. So it's definitely nickel. Oops. Now since this is 14 karat gold, and 24 carats is pure gold, this means that this is about 58% gold. If I multiply that by 28, which is the weight of the gold that I have, you can see that I have 16.3 grams if I manage to extract all of the gold from it. And that is, of course, assuming that the 14 carat is accurate, which sometimes it's not. Now, unfortunately, since this is 14 karat gold, I can't just put this in the aqua regia and then expect it to dissolve, because the silver content, which is what the base metal here is, this one has nickel, so I could probably drop this one and be fine, but these ones contain silver, and silver does not dissolve in aqua regia. In fact, if there's any more than about 10% silver, the silver will actually form a coating on the gold as soon as it hits the aqua regia, and it'll make it either not dissolve or it'll dissolve very, very slowly. So in order to be able to refine these, I'm actually going to mix the gold with some copper, approximately an equal mass to the 14 karat gold, because I want to decrease the gold content down to about 25%. That way I can actually dissolve the metal in nitric acid, and that'll leave me with gold powder, silver, and copper in solution. Silver, of course, will be easy to recover, and I'll have some gold powder to work with. Okay, here's the gold along with a bunch of copper. Let's put this together. I'm gonna put it in the furnace and melt it down. I'm gonna pour it into water to disperse it into tiny droplets to make it dissolve faster. Okay, here it goes. There we are. And yes, as you can see, I cleaned the stairs. I saw a few comments about that. People wanted me to clean up all those leaves so I didn't start a fire or something. So, well, this was melting. I did that. Another thing that people are commenting on a lot was the fact that I showed my mistakes in the last video. And you know what? I'm going to do that, because if you guys make the same mistakes, at least you'll be able to see how I solved them. Anyway, I'm going to add a little bit of distilled water to this, because dilute acids work more efficiently. You know, it'll use less acid overall. It may work a little bit slower. And now I'm going to add in some nitric acid. This is straight nitric, no hydrochloric, so it should only dissolve the silver and copper, leaving the gold behind, which is exactly what I want. Now I'm just going to add a little bit in for now. And then when this is all used up, I'll add a little bit more. Just like when dissolving the gold in aqua regia, this produces nitrogen dioxide gas, so it's better to do this outdoors while it's well ventilated. As you can see, I'm busy dissolving it away. I've been using a 50% strength of the 70% nitric acid. And every now and then I pour off the material. That way I can keep the acid's concentration up. That way I can dissolve it at maximum speed and with the greatest efficiency of the acid. Now you can see that this stuff has already begun to crumble up into a brownish powder. I like to crush it up a little bit between batches, you know, just to flake the gold off, make it react better. After dissolving away the copper and silver with nitric acid, you can see what I'm left with. A brownish powder, which is almost pure gold. Now I could melt this down right now and have probably 98% gold, or I could run it through acid and be able to make maybe 99.9% gold. I think I'm going to do the second one. Now, since this is very finely divided, the acid should dissolve it very quickly. Since I suspect that there's about 15 grams of gold here, I'm going to add in 60 milliliters of hydrochloric acid. There we go. Let's just fill it right to the 60 milliliter mark. And now I'm going to add in some nitric acid, but I'm not going to add it in all at once. I'm just going to add it in like a couple of milliliters at a time until the gold stops dissolving. There we go. I've dissolved the gold with what appears to be 5 milliliters of nitric acid. See, like I said, you'd be very surprised at how little you actually need. Okay, it's the next day, and this has been dried out. So hopefully there's no nitric in there. Also, hopefully I didn't get it too hot and bake the gold out. You know what, I think we're good. Looks like it's all dissolving. Right here's the solution that I poured off of the gold. This contains all of the copper and hopefully the silver. Now I need this beaker, so I'm going to transfer it into this other container for now. And actually, let's dilute this with a bunch of water, and let's precipitate the silver out. Now you'll remember, silver is incredibly insoluble if there's chlorine in the solution. So I got some hydrochloric acid here. Let's put this in, and you'll watch the silver fall out. There it is. Looks like cottage cheese is clumping up in there. That's your silver chloride. I don't know if you can see, but there's just a tiny little bit of silver in there. And that's what I was trying to remove by putting it through acid again. Now I'm going to pour in some boiling water. Here we go. You see, there's three things that affect settling rates. The first one is, of course, the particle size. Now I can't really change that, and the particle size here is going to be incredibly small. In fact, positively microscopic. The second thing that I can change is the temperature, because the higher the temperature, the faster it'll settle out. That's why I'm using boiling water. Make this as hot as I can get it. And the third thing that affects settling rates is the dilution. Like, the more concentrated the solution, the slower it'll settle out, because the particles like run into each other on their way down. Now I'm gonna use my preferred method of precipitating the gold, and that is to make some sulfur dioxide and bubble it into the solution. Sulfur dioxide is of course made by reacting soda metabisulfate, which came from stump remover, not the potassium nitrate stump remover. They actually make stump remover with soda metabisulfate. I'm going to put some hydrochloric acid into the metabisulfate, and that is going to produce sulfur dioxide gas, which is going to bubble through the solution and cause the gold to precipitate out. There you go. You can see the sulfur dioxide bubbling out already. There we go. Looks like I dropped out quite a lot of gold. Very nice. There's still a bunch in solution, so I'm going to set it here to stay warm as it settles out. Could take quite a while. And once it settles out, I'm actually going to check it with Stannis to make sure I got all the gold out. So I just took a piece of tin, metal, you know, metallic tin, and I put it inside this bottle with some hydrochloric acid. Very simple, and then I let it sit for a few days. The hydrochloric acid dissolves the tin into solution, and I have a solution of acidic stannous chloride, which is exactly what you want for testing for precious metals in solution. Let's demonstrate this real quick. Okay, so here's some pure water. I'm gonna add some stannous chloride to it, and you can watch what happens. So put in quite a bit there, give it a stir. As you can see, there's no color change whatsoever. I have a little bit of gold chloride here, which I'll put in using my stir stick. Here we go. Let's put in a little bit of that. Now you can see the color's changing. See that? See, it kind of gets to a purple color? That's because it precipitates out a colloidal gold. Is the tin actually is another thing that'll make gold fall out of solution. Looks like the silver's all settled out. As you can see, I've washed most of the copper out of the silver chloride. And now, to check to see that it is in fact silver chloride and not lead chloride, I'm gonna hit it with my laser. All right. You should see it darken because the light actually knocks the chlorine atoms off of the silver, leaving silver metal in a finely divided state, which will be a darkened color. Looks darkened to me. So now let's turn this into silver metal. It's probably not really worth doing, but I think you guys want to see it anyway. First thing I'm going to do is mix it with potassium hydroxide to convert the silver chloride into silver oxide. And then, I've never tried this before, but I'm going to try reacting it with fructose to see if that'll actually turn it into pure silver metal. If not, I'm just going to smelt the silver oxide and that'll leave a bead of nice silver anyway. Okay, so here's the potassium hydroxide. Let's dump this in. Oh look, there was a little bit of copper in solution. Oh well. It won't be pure silver, but we'll definitely convert this back to metal. Yeah, this should turn to a nice dark color. Yep, because it's turning it into silver oxide. The potassium hydroxide is taking the chlorine, making potassium chloride, and it's leaving the oxide for the silver to take. Alright, let's let this work for a little while. Now let's see if that sugar trick will actually work. Here's some fructose, and I think I need to heat this up a little bit. You know what? I think it is actually working. Camera can't see anything because it just fogged up. Now the particle size is not any different than it was, so it's not going to look like shiny or anything, but it's definitely whiter. So I can definitely tell it is now in a metallic form. So this is metallic spongy silver here. Well, I'm just going to melt this down now. Okay, we're up around 2000 F. Let's pull it out of there. Take this, I do this one-handed, I know. Let's pour it out. There you go, nice little bit of silver. That's really not very much, is it? Yeah, that's probably less than a gram. So while the silver was melting, I took the liberty of washing and drying out the gold powder, as you can see here. Let's put this into the crucible now and meld it down too. Look at that. It almost fills it. Actually, it does fill it. Yeah, there it is. It'll melt down. I can't wait to see that button. It's gonna be big. Alright, I think the gold should be melted by now. Let's have a look at it. Well, I can have a look at it. There it is. I think my tongs popped and some rust fell into it, but otherwise, it looks pretty good. Yeah, look at that. It's a shame about that little blemish on the top, but you know what? I'd say it's pretty, well, pretty. Oh, it's got a cavity in the back too. Maybe I cooled it too soon. Anyway, let's go weigh it. Nice fat bead of gold. Put it on the scale. 17 grams. Well, the scale's not super accurate, so that's probably just over 16 then. Very nice. So here's what I've gotten so far. You can see that I took that little blemish out of this bead here. I just put it in some hydrochloric acid and dissolved the rust away. And this is the bead that I got last episode. And here's a little piece of silver. Now it's much less silver than I was expecting. And I was a bit confused about that until I looked over at my waste jug here. And look at this. That. There's some silver chloride in the bottom of it. So, what must have happened is
Again, the pH was too high for the silver to drop out or something. And when I poured it off into this bigger jug, it all settled out. Yeah, so there's probably quite a bit of silver in there still. At least I know where it is. I'll extract it out of there eventually.
There's a couple more things I'd like to mention. First, that Daniel Desden sent me some catalytic converter material. He sent me some catalytic converter material. So I'm going to extract the platinum from this. So which means that this series, I guess, is no longer exclusively gold. So I'm going to change the name of it to Precious Metal Refining. And the last thing I'd like to mention is that I'm just an amateur. I'm doing this for fun. I'm by no means a professional. If you want to do this yourself, I recommend doing some extra reading and research on your own. And I definitely recommend this book here. I can get to the title page. Written by C.M. Hoke. Is Refining Precious Metal Wastes. It's a very good book. It's kind of expensive. I managed to find this on eBay, but I'll definitely link a place on the internet where you can get a free copy of this. Anyway, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.